music. When I met you in the summer.
Let me take a selfie.
Well, good morning. Morning of day two. And we slept pretty well. I think I only got up once because of the cold. And I think it's because the dog decided to go in the sleeping bag and pull the sleeping bag down as he went down towards my feet. But, so that left it open. So here's what the lake looks like. And I swear, it's only 8:30 right now. I swear about 6:30. Two people canoed by. I could hear them, and it was like at least 2 hours ago. What do you think, dog? Noticing on this tree here, I'll zoom in a bit. There we go. The way that the water is reflecting, the sun is water. The way that the sun is reflecting off the water, making the designs on the trees, is pretty cool. He's over there, snoring away. I don't know if you can hear him. There's Wrinkles, just hanging out on the log. All by himself. So I just wanted to show you the stove that we're using. It is the, I think it's the Pocket Rocket from MSR. And it's really good. We used it last night to boil water. Didn't take very long at all. And I'm gonna use it this morning to boil water for my coffee and my oatmeal, which today's breakfast is brought to you by Quaker. So we're gonna have the Quaker raisin and spice oatmeal, and I brought two of them. And I dehydrated some strawberries to give it a little bit of a flavor, if you will. And that's what I'm gonna have for breakfast. So Mo has decided to come out of bed. Good morning. That's a good morning. And I forgot that I had to make some coffee. So I just made myself a nice cup of coffee. I haven't stirred it, that's why it looks like that. And the secret ingredient is this. Irish cream. That's my cream for the morning. A little bit of Irish cream. In our little 1 liter platypus bag that's got trees on it. Isn't that cute? Yes. I saw a video once where the bag that the person left brought their stuff in kind of exploded all inside their carrying case, so I was very extra careful with that carrying case. So, when I say carrying case, I mean bear bag. Word lottery with me. Anyways, oatmeal's warming up, and I'm gonna have my coffee. Okay, so we're all packed up, and we're heading to Burnt Island now. Burnt Island Lake. We're all clean. This is a good sight, actually. Enjoyed it. We left all the some wood there for the next people. And we just had some people drive by. Give you a look. We're all ready to go. So, we'll see you at the next portage. Okay, so we avoided this portage. We actually just went around it. Since it is May, the water was high enough for us to go around.
Watch yourself, it's slippery now. I might have to put it down.
Why?
Can you help me here?
With what?
Well, hold it so I can get out.
Why? What's wrong?
It's heavy. Are you videotaping this?
These boots are made for walking, and that's just what they'll do. One of these days, these boots are gonna walk all over you. Yeah. You keep lying when you ought to be truthing, and you keep losing when you ought to not bet. You keep saying when you ought to be a champion.
Okay, so we're done that portage now. We're heading to Burnt Island Lake. We are tired.
You're tired.
Out of shape. Chach, we're going this way. Come on. Oh, there's a glare. Burnt Island. Come on. This is the trail. All muddy to Burnt. Our poor mascot's being dragged around there. You can see him flipping around. He's not doing much today. Later on today, there's going to be a sit down.
Poor mascot.
Don't do that. Later on today, there's going to be a sit-down interview with Wrinkles, and to find out what his experience is like so far. So you'll have to stay tuned for that. Should be great. But anyways, I'm gonna put the camera away so that we can go around this mud. Okay, bye. Okay, so we've decided that we're gonna take this site. I got a bag. Now, I think I've seen this site before on one of the YouTube channels that I'm subscribed to. Pine Martin, Camper 905, Bivicus Bradley, I think, Ian Young, Maddie the Goose, and I think I said Camper 905. So, because this fireplace up here looks familiar. Now, 6 or 5 canoes just left this site, so they were camping here last night, and this fireplace, really cool and really neat. But the only thing is, we've got these little tiny chairs that sit on the ground and it's really up high. So we're gonna steal those wood there. The bathroom is a little bit up the way, which is kind of cool though. So, and it's got a great view of the valley right now. I'll take you up there to see. Chach is doing much better today. And there's the Thunderbox. And we'll open it just in case it's wet. Let it dry out a bit. It's good. And this is our view. So this is actually not a bad campsite. I don't mind it. Here's our view. Now the wind is coming up, but we're going to choose to put our camp or our tent actually right down there where Mo is. And there was somebody else had a fire there, so we might use that pit instead of this one. I know we're not supposed to, but others have, so. Okay, so here's our wood that we've collected. Brush and all that stuff. Here's the fire. I made this little thing to put Mo's shoes on because he got his shoes wet. So we'll put his shoes on there once the fire gets going, or now, it doesn't matter. There you go.
Is that the way?
I guess so. It's the way I think it should look. This was actually cut down from the people that were here before us. It was live. They took the twigs off, so I don't really know how far they got with a live tree, but whatever. So I just used the remnants of it. I also made some, oh, never mind, it broke. They were clothespins. So to keep them up. Apparently the one broke though, so didn't work so well, but oh well. We'll put the tent here. It's not really windy per se because the wind's going the other direction, so it's a nice view, but oh well. So we put our bear barrel rope up. Trying to find a spot in this site is ridiculous because all the branches are way up there and you can't get nothing up there. So we've decided we're going to use this one, which is over the water, and it looks, I wasn't swinging on it, but I was yanking on that branch. It's pretty solid. So it will be out, up, and down enough that nothing should be able to get to it. So here's our fire, and in there is our pita pizza. We were gonna buy a reflector oven to bring with us, but we didn't get around to it. So hopefully that worked. This works. There's Mo making another one.
Yeah, this is a rehydrated sauce.
With mushrooms.
With mushrooms. We have a lot of cheese and pepperoni, so they're gonna be extra cheesy and extra meaty.
There we go. You can see our pizza, and it's got ashes on it. It's not ashes, they're spices. Take that, Little Caesars. Pizza, pizza. Oh, that, those are two different things,
yeah,
aren't they?
Those are two different things. Now you're tired,
one. Do you like our shoe rack? It's drying Mo's shoes.
I don't even know if it's working.
There's our two pizzas that we may not get to because these forgot.
They're stick piles.
Forgot.
Or twigged.
I forgot how long it takes for things to cook out here.
Oh, you can actually see some of these. Ooh. Getting some seasoning on them.
But our fire is pretty good. We've got these two big logs that somebody left here, and then our other sticks that are crap, but whatever. It's working. Okay, so we finally have some nice coals on this side and found out that it's a lot easier to cook your pizza when there's coals. So there's our pizza. And somebody left their lovely paper here for us. How are you?
I'm great.
Welcome to another edition of Campfire Stories.
Was there a first edition?
This is the first edition.
Oh, you said another.
Well, I know. I meant that. So anyways, how was your second day of camping, Mr. Wrinkles?
Well, to be honest with you, it was a blast. I had a lot of fun riding in the canoe. I tag teamed with the dog for a bit. And we set up this lovely fire.
And how much wood have we put on this lovely fire?
I haven't done any of it personally.
Okay, and how was supper? What did we have for supper?
Well, I saw you two. Not the dog, the other handsome fellow there. You guys had pita pizza.
And how did we say the pita pizza was?
You said it was good.
Good. And how do we like this site?
Well, there seems to be some poop. What are you doing?
So you had some hair on your...
What did I tell you about touching me?
Nothing.
You think it's okay to stick your hand up in me? Stick your hand in me? In my mouth?
Okay, so what are we doing tomorrow?
Tomorrow? Well, first you said we're gonna stay here the night.
Yeah, tomorrow. So what are we doing tomorrow?
Tomorrow? This thinking stuff's hard for me. I've just been out of a box for like a month. I was neglected for Well, since 1985.
No.
We're going on another portage trip tomorrow.
And what lake are we going to tomorrow?
I'd have to consult the map.
Okay.
But I know.
I think we're going to Little Doe tomorrow.
That's right.
Little Doe.
Little Doe.
That's right.
There's a 1,140 meter portage.
Is that how long it is? We have the 200 from here to there, and then...
I'm a puppet moose. Why are you asking me?
I don't know.
Oh.
Okay, so far you're enjoying the trip, then.
Well, I mean,
The answer is yes.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I'm enjoying the trip.
Give a little wave to the camera with your arm.
You're a bit stiff after paddling all day.
Okay. And that's another episode of Campfire Stories.
You can't say another episode. There's only been one episode.
Well, we'll have one tomorrow night.
Oh, boy.
When Jace was at the table, I kept on seeing him look at me while he's with that other girl. Do you think he was just doing that to make me jealous? Because he was totally texting me all night last night, and I don't know if it's a booty call or not. So, like, what do you think? Did you think that girl was pretty? How did that girl even get in here? Do you see her? She's so short, and that dress is so tacky. Who wears cheetah? It's not even summer. Why does the DJ keep on playing Summertime Sadness? After you get out of the bathroom, can we go smoke a cigarette? I really need one. But first, let me take a selfie.